finally we're ready to go, ready to jump into the game.
All right, let's get to it, ladies and gentlemen. Big will be starting off on the CT side with Rogue on the T side. Let's make some noise. It is time to get into our second loser's match here, our final loser's match before we head to the lower bracket finals of both of our groups. Tapsin, as we can see starting off here, he's going to get a little bit of a glimpse of that smoke that's been tossed up, but he looks away just as one of the T's goes for the cross over there out of Palace, and there's nobody else really watching for the cross back down over there on T ramp, so they're able to waltz up freely. This is a lot of control being given. Kiev, though, does sneak in a kill, and Gabi falling back, tries to go into this little pit there and CT spawn, but that's not going to play out. Next, though, picks up two quick kills from back there and instantly puts a shutdown onto that aggression up from the T's. Tensi's going to try to make a change up onto this, but now they're boxed back in here. Glaze can't do anything from his position. He's stuck here, and Tensi's destroyed by Next. His third kill in this round. Glaze is also stuck in the corner, and there you have it. Big with a swift retake. They'll start off with a pistol round victory here in this set.
That was perhaps a 10 too aggressive from Rogue coming in there. They got the bomb there, they got the control of the A bomb site, and then they pushed two guys into CT. Of course, it's good to have map control over that CT, but still, when you're challenging a guy like Next long range with the USPS, that's just the number one thing you cannot do playing T side going up against CTs. Don't challenge a good player with good aim and a long range.
I think going off on a tangent here for a second, Glaze is another player too that hasn't really been discussed too much. He was actually incredibly potent in their performance last week in a lot of their matches too, specifically when it came to just got consistently picking up kills with like an AK. His headshot accuracy was off the charts in some of those games with how proficiently he was able to do that, so it's going to be interesting to see if he brings that out again, as it was a bit inconsistent until the last couple of days where he really seemed to kind of get into gear, but it seemed like it took him a little bit to get used to the environment that he was playing in and when he really found that. But a Rogue, again, not too heavy of an investment in this second round. They tried to push quickly through the B halls, but now they've been forced to fall back over towards C spawn, and I think this is going to be red too pretty quickly. We can already see Big adjusting to it and starting to send their players back over to A.
Yeah, they're going to be completely ready for this, I think. Or B is even going to put down a Molotov, which is going to hold them even longer to get that rotate in. We actually also have a flank coming in, Kiev coming in from behind with a UMP 45, and he catches the first one. No, actually does not get him down, but does a ton of damage. But now he meets the full force of Rogue, and Rogue now rotating. They have picked up this UMP 45. Technically, they're one man up, low HP, but still, this is doable. It's going to be incredibly hard. But let's see here, two players on this A bomb site from Big. One of them is Scott B, posted up very aggressively here in the palace.
Now Gabi pushing in. He's going to be able to find that first one. That's Tensky gone down. Didn't catch the other. He's actually expecting them to push in towards the ramp right now, but that's actually going to be non-existent. I can see Kadian had moved himself down over towards, I believe, the underpass. Now he's going to try to sneak in through connector, kind of acting as a distraction, but nice positioning from Gabi. Him and Next, along with Tabs and 2 as he chimes in there. Just going to shut this down. Kadian with 7 HP. We'll see if he can find one, but nope, not going to be the case. Tabson shuts it down. It's going to be a clean 2-0 start from Big.
Yeah, now with the 2-0 start and the bomb being planted in that first round, we are going to see AKs coming in from the Rogue team on this T side. So the question is, how will Big handle this incoming AK push? Because if they do kind of like the same as they did in the pistol round, with a quick push onto that A bomb side and not really having the big players ready for that initial point and clearly going for the retake instead, that's going to be a trouble, because if we can get Rogue into the post-plant positions with the AK, that's going to be very favorable towards the OMP45s. But look at that, Gopi getting the first one, going for the second, doing the damage though. Tensky on 52, so good trade for the CTs.
Bubble as well here at the end of the smoke. Was thinking about going in for a second here too. They're still very spread out, so that forward of a move in here, while not actually having the bomb ready to deploy into the site, would be somewhat unadvisable, considering it would take a lot of time to regroup there and actually get the bomb onto the site. But Leggy now is going to get boosted up over here to watch out a little bit better for any mid-action. It's non-existent right now. Rogue are spread out on the outskirts of the site. I'm not sure if Kiev
saw
that player outside of the palace area a moment ago, so Bubble's still under view. No, he saw him there, as he does go for the jump up to try and find him. So they are aware of it, as Bubble, however, still stays in this position. The Molotov not going to affect him, and he is free to move out a little bit here to hunt down and see if he can find any additional intel on this site. He's actually going out really wide, and that is unfortunately where he's going to meet his end against Tapsin. Kiev as well, holding the close angles. The rest of Rogue get ready to try and push their way in here through the ramp. The flashbang was ready to deploy it a second ago, but again, a last moment decision there actually works out. He's able to duck in. There's a little bit of a hole in the smoke, and he uses it. Takes down Katie, and that's the bomb gone down too, and he's just going to re-smoke it.
Perfect, 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 perfect. He can hold that smoke with the UMP 45 and actually forces the terrorists to go completely other way around on the map. And as that is happening, Big R rotating two players, one going aggressively up mid, and one rotating straight to the defensive point of the B bomb side. There's just no chance that Rogue are going to do anything in response. Actually, Glaze just steps in and get a headshot. Should not actually have happened if Legis has just held his angle. But still, it's a 1v3 with, well, 13 seconds to go. Let's say the odds are not high.
Yeah, Glace probably not going to have a whole lot of chance of doing this, but he's going to be ducking down, looking to try and see if he can take out these players, but it's not going to play out. Key moves in, shuts them down before the timer expires, so obviously he's going to get the money for that one, but still, overall, another shutdown coming in for the German roster.
There we go. Shut down completely by the Germans, and the Danes and the Bulgarian has to they have to rethink what they've been doing so far, and they are going to do almost a full eco around here, just buying a couple of pistols and then rebuying in this next coming round. So Rogue technically are going to be on a 4-0 lead here to start off things on Mirage, but of course Mirage being a CT map, you want to get the majority of your rounds on the CT side.
And God beat, they do actually catch on to the fact that he's been playing fairly aggressively here, so they start spraying into that, get some great damage going. Tapson though back in the picture here, taps on one of them, taking down Victor, finds a trade for that, but still move on to the site very quickly, and Kaden's gonna sneak that kill too. Here comes Keeve back from CT position. He's found two. Nex actually tabbing in there for a second as well to help out. He kind of saves his teammate's life, and then Legia, it's the final kill. It was looking actually like they were gonna be able to hold good control of the site and find a plant and everything, but then all of a sudden that retake comes in really quickly and Big denies it.
Yeah, very good job from Big. Just holding a standard push, and that's something you need to be able to do as well to be a consistent team. You have to be able to hold these explosive pushes despite them getting the first drag. Keeve doing a good job here, just gunning people down, and now we're into the interesting round. The first buy round of this game, the first real buy round, because Kadian is on an AWP, Keeve is on an AWP. We actually have Godby still sticking to the UMP 45, and that might be a problem coming in later to this round, but economy-wise, that is a wise move.
We see that pretty often. That's been a fairly standard thing that everybody's been doing nowadays, too, is they just save with the SMGs to allow them to rebuy in the event they lose the first gun round. So anyway, TFSin nice. And Keeve with a nice shot there are going to open up with the first two kills in this one, and already stunning the possibilities for Rogue to even get into a bomb site to begin with. Their other mid players going to have to fall back and regroup. As these other two are positioned, they did get themselves out initially.
I'm kind of wondering why they don't smoke CT
there it is.
Like early night, but before walking up the ramp, you know there's going to be an AWP. You know Keeve is a very good AWP player, and he's probably going to play on this A bomb site to begin with. Why don't you just smoke off CT to be sure, instead of just walking two players up with the AKs? You could have walked up with Kadian, but he was not there. So that just seems strange to me from Rogue. It's almost like they banked on Keeve not being there with the AWP.
You can see Keeve specifically again chiming in once again with that AWP. He's found Bubblegum down now in these last two. I mean, Tenski had a position a moment ago back over there on Tetris to play with in case they got aggressive, which, you know, they've been no strangers to doing that previously, even in the mid-round situation. But Ali falling back, they give that up, and now they got to reapply their only smoke that they had left here just to get themselves out. And, well, the CTs know that this is on its way, so they're going to push forward because they need the intel. They need to make sure they're even going into the site with a timer. They still could have technically rotated over towards the B site. Finally, they will begin to move in, but it's very obvious what they're doing now. It's little damage done to Big at all. They'll be ready for this one, and there you go. Keeve hooklining himself into another shot, and they've got the last player on lock. Legia shuts it down, and it will be yet another round for the Big roster.
So hopefully the coach and basically the in-game leader, Kadian and Lomé from Rogue will now know that, okay, we have to smoke off every single possible position that Keeve can be in, especially the CT position. That's almost like, if you want to do an A-split, want to go in towards the A-bomb side, you always have to smoke off that CT, because just the chance of an AWP being there, you just wreck your entire team. And when into an AWP player like Keeve, who is the best player on this Big lineup, there's just no way that you should not do that. So surely, coming the next A push, we're going to see smokes coming to CT.
And I believe we go into a pause here now as well for the guys over on Rogue. A very well-needed one. They're just not finding any traction here. Their gun rounds that they've played so far have been pretty lackluster. You can see like Kadian kind of aggressively explaining that now, going over the issues that they're running into. They just can't even find any entries, to be completely honest here. They're falling flat right from the beginning of every round, and it's Big that hold the advantage like 99% of the time.
Yeah. Definitely, and I think it's a correct call to take it so early into the game, because you don't want to let these German players like run away with the lead, because they are very, very good and they will punish every single mistake you make. So better to correct those mistakes earlier on in the game. Get some feedback in from your coach, because I know Lomé is a very analytical coach, so he has everything prepared and he's reading the game while it's happening, and the timeout allows him to give his feedback to the team and kind of answer, okay, what went wrong, what can you do differently, and then give that communication to Kadian, and then let Kadian feed that out towards the team. And then now with the round coming in here, and I'm not sure if they're actually going to go for the buy here, but definitely the next buy round we're going to see something very, very different coming up for Rogue, surely.
It's got to be a change up here. I mean, overall though, this is going to be the big issue with them, is what exactly can they adjust for this one. It's still with it being so early on, there's still a lot of things that they can try to deploy towards. Like their overall play towards mid has been pretty non-existent. I think they've tried to go for it on one or two rounds, which was met with, again, pretty good aggression that's come out from Big, which has been working really well for them on the CT side so far, but they haven't actually tried to play for, like, with an op or anything like that. But also, you know, if they're able to adjust themselves to get better control of mid, they can basically springboard off of that into any take that they want to play towards.
So here you go. Scoreline reads 5-0 for a German team of Big. Rogue non-existent on the scoreboard so far, and we're about to jump into the game once again here on DE Mirage. Of course, map number one in this best of three, so there's plenty of Counter-Strike to go around, especially during today where we not only have this one but two more best of threes. But now back into the game. This is the kind of weird force scrappy buy where they do buy full armor on Tech-9s and some utility and a scout on Kadian, hoping for him to get an opening pick. It does the damage, but that's not really enough.
Kadian, the race car, just speeding in there with the scout zoomed in the whole time as well. He does tag Legia, but unfortunately, Op is still going to win in that situation, so they take him down pretty quickly. He had a couple teammates stacked behind him, but this is still the spread out play that we saw previously from Rogue, which hasn't been met with much success. I imagine that much like these past attempts at it too, they are eventually going to fall back from the B hall as the second player is, and then Bubble's just going to regroup and they'll try to push this into A again. But without, like I was saying, without the mid control, obviously yeah. Big will put one or two players on it, but as soon as they realize that it's an all-in hit again, they can just divert all their attention to it, and it's going to be very easy to stop that kind of a play.
So here we go. Scout switched over to Tensky, so he's going to be the one trying to open up while the rest of his team are going to be the one throwing their smokes and the flashbangs, going over towards the site. And this is going to be an A-tick for sure with 50 seconds gone. Here we go, Tech-9s against fully bought up CTs.
And as they start to move in here, we can already see the smokes being deployed in, trying to block these guys off here. It's actually a good flash against Tabson, so he cannot directly contest this. They'll move over towards jungle, but they're going right into Tabson. These are free kills for him, essentially, as they leap through the smoke. Leggy has found the third kill against Glace, and it's just Tensky now, and he's completely backed out of the site.
But they did get the bomb down, though, so that's at least something. Of course, there's no way that Tensky's going to be able to clutch this one, but with the bomb going down, they will have some money. So I'm interested in what they're going to do in this next coming around. But yeah, this round is pretty much over. Going to smoke off the bomb. God Beast going to drop on it, and they're probably going to... Oh, okay. Tensky's running away, so they're going to have that scout and head armor and Tech-9 coming into the next round. But nonetheless, it's a 6-0 lead for Big.
Yeah. And it's not looking like it's going to be changing anytime soon here. Obviously, the guys from Rogue will get their next chance to buy into this pretty soon. However, like we've mentioned many times already, big changes are needed overall strategically here for them to try and make an impact. They cannot keep going for these direct A plays as they're going to get countered out. And here comes this next fire on from Rogue now. Full investments. They've got the op on Kadian once again. Full utility. They've basically got everything they need. Now we need to see if they make any change-ups here, which can actually lead to some positive impact for them. And at the moment, it's looking like a repeat of what we saw in the last round yet again.
Now, why did he save the scout though if they were going to go for the full buy here? That's just plain weird to me. But nonetheless, we do have, as you say, this big investment coming in from both teams. We have two AWPs on that CT side. Throwing a bit of a utility away early on in the round. So we see right now Nex has no flashbangs left, only an 8-copy, no flashbangs, no smokes either. So this could be quite interesting coming into the execute from Rogue. Victor's trying to make his way in, and they also have Glaze posted up in the palace. So this looks like it could be an A split with, I'm not sure, it's at Kadian, yeah, Kadian in underpass on towards that opposite bomb site. So he's probably going to try and hold a few players there while his teammates are going to attack B, and then he's going to do the flank.
We can see the smoke starting to get set up now. In comes the A play yet again. We will see if this has any impact now. Kadian's also going to be tossing one. I believe we'll see where this one gets tossed over towards in a moment here too, as they all throw them back in. That should cover essentially every avenue on the site. But Gobby still has a good position inside to counter out the palace play. And also, if he keeps himself quiet enough to possibly act as a really good player, they can kind of jump out in the post plan, which is Rogue's main focus right now, is to get that bomb on the ground. Gobby jumps out way too early though, so they know he's here now, and they will take him down. That's Glace that finds the kill. Tensky falling back out of the site. Big doesn't even, you know, really know how to start this retake yet, as they didn't have a clue where these players are moving into due to the smoke setups. There's Leggy with the first one. Victor set up to try and counter out mid aggression, but he looks away at the wrong time. Tabson also walks in, and he finds Bubble going down too. They line it up. It's a good repeat from Glace to be able to train on a Tabson, but he's now bringing this down to a 1v3 as he's gone out. Tensky tries to hold, attempts to transfer that spray. He's seen the shadow of his opponent, and while he does take down Kiev, Legia will finish the job. It'll be a close defuse, but I believe that they're going to get it, and Big will have a 7.
Yeah, definitely. That was one of the rounds that I expect to see from Rogue. Good executions, wall of smokes coming in towards the A side, taking that bombsite. Got B, very unlucky that he didn't get that. But that hold in connector, That was just atrocious from Rogue. They were just not ready for Tapton coming in there, and he just cleaned them up. Two quick kills. And that was pretty much what started the retake and really got the round home for Big. So now 7-0, another full buy coming in from Rogue. They got this bomb down once again, so they have Atomic Cone to be going, but still lacking utility on this T side.
I think it was still a good attempt from Rogue, though. In fact, the way that they go and take the site is really great. It's just the post plant that was really sloppy from them. If that had been tightened up a little bit better, there's no doubt in my mind that they would have taken control of that round. So at the very least, finding a good strat to use here, it's just now cleaning it up and actually being able to pick up a few of these rounds here. They need to do it soon. Already 7 rounds on the board for Big. And well, look at this. They're not even checking towards the van position. Nexus is just freely cleaning up these kills. And what? He walks forward. They should have been able to hear that. But no, he gets a second and even a third against Victor before finally going down to Glace. It's Kadian and Glace now as the last two alive. Glace is stuck behind the big white van back over here. And they even tag him through that too. He does trade that, but the Molotov burns him up. And Kadian, in the meanwhile, is way over here on Cat. Let's see what he can do in the 1v3.
Oh, wow, that was just, well, perfect from Nex, but also many mistakes in a row from Rogue there. You mentioned it, first not checking the van, then knowing there's a player down there, not checking every single angle as you jump in, just moving straight into the bomb site. That big mistake as well. Kadian is edging in on this Molotov, but he's 1v3. He needs a miracle right now, and look at that. Keeve's just ready for his position, and oh.
Kind of bait it.
Yeah, there it is.
It's not going to work out.
Solid job.
And with Keeve shutting things down there, and the big plays on the site. That will just lead into another round for the guys on Big. They're not struggling with this round at all right now, and it's the guys on Rogue that are making so many mistakes. Look at this, there's no way the Nex should be able to pull this off. He gets the first one. All right, that one we can rub off a little bit. It's the second one that's insane, as they just cannot catch his position amongst the chaos, and then he even somehow gets this third one against Victor too, before finally getting traded out by that player on the top right of the screen.
Yeah, the problem is they're all, like, all focused on getting into the side really quickly, but that's a problem if there's a player that's rotating around. Keeve just getting tons of damage done, but the second orb in Legia just getting one as well. Tensky quickly revenging, and now they're into this little house here in the middle, and Nex is trying to challenge, but that should not happen. And there goes the revenge track. 2v2, this is probably one of the better chances that Rogue has had so far in this first half. So they need to convert this into a round, or else they'll be completely screwed by the end of this first half.
So Gabi is now going to sneak back over here towards the B-bomb set. We can see Rogue as well, trying to figure out what exactly is going to be their best option here. But Tensky starts to investigate over here. Get some fire back over on the B-bomb site. The key thing, obviously, is the fact that they've left A undefended, yeah. So Bubble's been free to kind of lurk in here. He's called it off, and Tensky will obviously start to push his way into here, too, even deploying the smoke to stop for the early rotate in case they catch him on the backside, which, yeah, that's great for this position, as if the smoke wasn't there, there's a good chance Gabi might have been able to cut one or two of them off if he'd been 2 seconds earlier. Not the case now, though. And the bomb goes down, the timer starts ticking, but Bubble's gonna remain aggressive, and Tensky goes completely out of the site. So they're giving these CTs free access to it in hopes that they can lurk around them and just flank these kills out. Gabi inside now. They're ready to toss over the smoke to try and isolate these guys a little bit, but that flank will soon be moving in. It's Bubble, but he just missed his chance against Gabi. He successfully snuck over to the sandwich, and it will lead into a battle with Tensky. Time's getting low, though, and this is actually really well played from Rogue, as they still don't have a clue where they're at, but now in comes the defuse. Can they actually take him down in time? And they can! Tensky and Bubble capitalize on a really passive play, but it's really well played, and it allows them to finally pick up a round here.
Yeah, that was really, really well played by Rogue, and the first round we've actually seen them do something really good. I like the decision from Big to play for the retake, actually. Just stack the B side instead of playing 1-1, just stacking 2 on the B side and then hoping for them to go there. And if not, then they're going to retake together. That's actually quite smart, but in this end, it doesn't really pay off because of Rogue's setup really was just on point. Kadian missing a shot there, that's very uncharacteristic, especially as in Kai of easy angle. But look at that, Legia just peeking short and just getting frags done. Left, right, and center takes out Glace as well. And just get wrecked, Rogue, completely.
It's a shooting gallery in mid, led by the operatives of the CT side. Leggy and Keeve already stacking up 3 kills. Kadian trying to respond to this. He spotted one of the whoppers over there on the right side, but he's not able to capitalize on it. Finally, we have a kill being picked up here. Bubble takes down Keeve, eliminates one of the operatives. They have to be very careful in trying to get this bomb back, though, as Leggy is still very much a factor over here. Oh, there you go. Swipes the kill onto Bubble away, and now it is just Kadian in the 1v3. He lines up that first one. There is going to be a repeat, though, and he's not accounting for that. So Legia shuts it down. It's another round for Big.
Great round once again, and that's so important for both confidence and money. When the other team gets one round back, you just smack them back into the ground straight afterwards. Helped your economy really well because it destroys theirs and the loss bone is now gone. But also for the confidence, if you feel like you've finally got a match under control, you win that round and then you get smacked straight after. That's just going to tilt off the face of the planet straight off. And I know some of these players on Rogue, they're really battling with this mental state in the game, and this is not going to really do well for them.
And the reset is going to hit them pretty hard too, as they do just force right into a 20 out their bank accounts. Only two AKs to be utilized by Bubble and Victor. The rest are on upgraded pistols. Only one of those three has armor to play with. Kadian choosing to optimize towards utility instead. And they will waste no time. It's right back to the A site, which has been their forte. They'll rush into it. Tapson, unfortunately, not able to find much early on. And not only that, but Victor's taken down Gabi back over here by Ticket. The rotates will come in quickly, and Tapson starts this off well. Keeve lining in. He spotted that rifle on the left side, and he's just going to inch out that kill. He takes down Victor. The other three have again backed up to the site. They're going to try to play this passive style once again. However, they don't have nearly as much utility to be able to try and bait this out as before, and the CT still have plenty of their own. In fact, four, all of the players still alive, have smokes. In fact, one of which was just thrown out there. In comes Bubble, though. He's going to get aggressive now, jumping back in towards Tetris. He's found Keeve, ducking back behind to bait them towards it, but reloads at the wrong time. And that's where Next is going to pick up not one, not two, but three kills against all of the remaining players there. And once again, they will continue to shut down the offensive coming in from this T side and rack up the rounds as they get up the double digits.
Yeah, really well played by Big, and everyone in this team is looking perfect so far in his role. Keeve with the AWP, Legia with that secondary AWP as well, and then Tabs and Next coming in with the rifles as well. Gobby, of course, in the bottom of the scoreboard. Doesn't really matter because that's not his role. So he's also fulfilling every single thing they need to do, and that is why they're in the lead, 10-1. Now we do see a full pistol buy here coming up from Rogue, full buy completely from Big, so there's not going to be much competition in this round, to be honest. A Rogue going to be on the full buy on the round after, and they need that. They need that round to have a chance in that one, to be honest.
Tensky's hunting to see if he can find the feet. I think he can see just below that smoke, but nobody else is crossing it right now. Bubble, though, elsewhere, he's found the kill. He's taking down Keeve early on here. That flashbang is going to completely blind Tensky. Full control for Gabi as he does inch out the headshot against Tensky there.
Cheeky.
And Glace as well waits to see if anybody from Big is going to try to jump over this that he can have a headshot on, but there's nothing lining up for these Rogue players right now.
Yeah, Next holding down with patience on this B-bomb side. Kadian in the meanwhile, underpass just waiting. They've actually they got two players right now towards the B-bomb side. That is a correct decision because the bomb is slowly making its way there with 55 seconds to go. There's still going to be some waiting time before an eventual push happens. So Bubble and Kadian are going to go out to middle and see if they can find a single frag and then maybe get a weapon, rotate back to B-horse and then push B.
For right now, the Rogue are still keeping themselves rather quiet. They do have to send Glace over. Kadian's going to be first at the bat inside, though. He just wanted the op. Yeah. As he moves in, he grabs that. And he's actually able to get away without taking any additional damage. So they escape with the op. Now what are they going to do, though? As Legia just expects this since they just retreated in an underpass.
Yeah, definitely. This is the B push that I mentioned earlier. They now have an AWP, but if they are going to die off straight to Legia, it's not going to be that big of a competition. Bubble now with the AWP, and a Deagle has to rotate, but he's going to be flanked from the back. That's Tapson, and well, gymnastics not gonna do anything for you there.
A bit awkward there, but it does still end with Big shutting it down. Now, I mean, what we saw from Kadian, I imagine could have worked a lot better had it happened with, like, you know, 30, 40 seconds on the clock still, as there's the possibility for them to have fallen back and gone over to the A site and rotate it still. But the problem is with the time being that low, and yeah, this was fantastic, of course. Javi works his way into that corner, spots the player, and even waits for us to switch the observer over to him as we had it on the live camera there. But going back to what I was saying, with what we had going on with the op pickup there, potentially could have worked around. But the problem is with him doing that, then falling back at underpass with that little time left on the clock, it's very obvious that they were going to go to B. So they got a perfect read on that, and Big just positioned essentially for an apartments push, which was the only option at that point in time.
Nade coming in, not doing much damage. Tensky is the only one really affected by it. Takes some damage from the rifle as well. Now on 56, but this is the round where they need to have something going on for the Rogue, or else this map is going to be completely dropped, in my opinion. Let's see here. They do have a couple of smokes. And Kadian is thinking about what they're going to do here. How are they going to break this German powerhouse Big? Because it has not been looking easy so far for them.
Still now with Rogue trying to inch their way over here towards mid and into the apartments, though. Glace leads the charge over there. And it's Kadian again that plays around over there towards the underpass and tries to get a position on mid. Also, apologies, he won't be in underpass this round. He'll be over towards top mid, but they still have two more there, guys, including the bomb. Victor actually leads the charge this time as they move in. Him and Tenski will move up towards this spot. Now, the connector is where things will get a little bit interesting, as you do have Keeve currently watching over there towards the ramp push itself. So they don't have a whole lot of attention on connector. And with these smokes, there isn't that chance that Rogue could sneak in. So we'll wait and see as to where Rogue chooses to go here. Again, they're running the timer down very low too. There's only 30 seconds on the clock, but now they've been revealed and Keeve is dodging bullets from behind the plywood there. He only takes 3 damage. They were hoping they could maybe sneak in that kill, and there's their first strike now against Tapson. Keeve, he actually is baited into taking that shot there, so his first chance is gonna miss. He does re-peek and pick up the kill against Victor, but then Tenski trades him out. He'll go down. And it'll be a 3v4 now as these guys move into the site with only 8 seconds on the clock. Here comes Gabi, though. He played this position once before. They're not even paying attention to it, but that's a messy spray. He's able to readjust, gets the first one. Trade comes in from Tenski. Next now chiming in, however. He takes down Tenski, and this goes to a 2v2.
This is actually possible. With Next coming in, he does have the kit. Same does Legia, but Legia is on an orb. That's not the weapon you want to have in a retake situation. The two terrorist players can just play out the time, but that was the last flashbang, the last utility on that T side. So now they have to peek, and Next is just straight going for it. Is he going to get it? That must have been with seconds to go, and now it's all on Legia with 15 HP, 1v2, surely he's going to save it, and he will be shut down by Bubble, but that must have been seconds away from getting that defuse.
Worst thing is, too, is he backs into his teammate, which is defusing the bomb. If he stays out in the open, potentially, if they're targeting him instead, obviously we didn't see how close they were to the defuse, but there is that possibility that it would have taken them too long to adjust, and he would have gotten it. However, though, still a victory for Rogue, finally, and they have another chance to, at the very least, pick up an 11-4 scoreline, which they can try to battle back from on their CT side.
Let's see here, Keeve once again in the middle, of course. Star player of the team, actually just an edge in that smoke, so if Kadian or Tenski goes out, now he's just going to be nailed to the cross completely. There's nothing they can do there, but look at that Leia pushing up middle, waiting for the flashbang, and then pushing straight in.
And he's going to go right for it, too. They're all affected by the flash. He will only get one. But it's the read on the play that's really big here. It's unfortunate that it happens so early in the round, so they can't really adjust based on this. But still, now Keeve can prepare for the top presence, and if they do push into it, and he can expect at least two players to move in from there eventually.
They're actually sending yet another player off into top mid. That's Tapson. But all the terrorists have vacated the area and now are heading towards that B plateau, that B palace. While one player is ready to fake it on towards the A bomb site, and that's going to be Bubble.
This is going to give them a good possibility to line up for a flank early on, too, if Tapson decides to push forward a bit more here. Next is starting to expect that they haven't really seen anything else work its way out into the A site since here. Bubble, however, could change that if he's able to get a nice tap onto this player over here by Ticket. As this is the only guy in the A site right now, but he could sell this on his own since they're waiting for him in the B site. There we go, he snuck in, but he hasn't noticed the guy towards Ticket yet, so he's still trying to establish a foothold here. He does sneak in, he spots him a little bit late, but there's that kill. He's gotten into the zone. However, the rotations are still going in the right direction for the CTs. They've spotted the B hit now. Next is holding a position behind Arches. He gets one, he gets two, he almost gets the third. Tenski trades, but the damage is done. Both the remaining T's are split up. Tenski's gonna plant this, but he's instantly, no, he doesn't even get the plant. Gabi shuts him down through the smoke, and with only 18 seconds left, Bubble has to rush over to the B bomb site and just try to DM this out, essentially. He'll run up Cat, but they'll certainly know he's there with the player on Arch. Tapson throws at the smoke, but he goes the wrong way. Bubble gets the clothesline kill. 7 seconds left in the clock now as Bubble looks for this last frag, and I don't think he's going to be able to find it. He's checking the complete wrong position. And with this, Gabi will certainly win the round, but now can he kill this T in time? It doesn't look like he's going to be able to find them. Unfortunately, both will save their guns, but still, the disconnection, what originally started off as a benefit to the guys on Rogue, ends up turning into a deficit when their entire B hit is destroyed once again by Nex.
Yeah, it almost seemed like they were holding individual positions toward Nex, because the first player is supposed to check him and get that frag, but then the two remaining parts don't go for the instant revenge, and that allows him to do the re-peek and actually have his aim in position. So I'm kind of wondering why they didn't just jump all three down, because they have to believe in the fact that Bubble sells the fake, so they don't really have to check those angles coming in straight off. And not taking the bomb side, that cost them the round, basically, because if they all jumped in, they would have killed Nex, got the bomb down, gotten into good post-plant positions, and now they lost the round, and they're in this last round of the first half, and they're 2-12.
Legia, for the first time as well here, actually not being one of the first times in a while, I should say, not being able to work with the AWP. Same thing for the double AWP setup, essentially, is their money's actually a little bit low as they go into the last round here. Still, however, though, Rogue is in a much more dire position, and although they get early control here at mid, the early read still goes into the favor of Big. They've picked up the two kills against Kadian and Tenski. Bubble finally responding, but there's a great pop flash that goes into connector. Tapson, though, just cannot inch out that hitbox there. He's not going to be able to find a lot of damage. He still knows they're in here, and Keeve actually goes out to the open, too. Victor will find that kill, but in comes Nex with the P90, and he's going to destroy the last three. Big 13-2, a massive scoreline advantage here, and they are looking strong to take easy control of this first map.
Yeah, very well played by Big, but I have to say I'm quite disappointed in Rogue, to be honest. They looked absolutely perfect coming off that global challenge land and looked really good against LDLC in the final. And now they're coming here actually looking okay against Vega Squadron. But this has just been appalling from them, to be honest.
Yeah, unfortunately, this was always the big worry is how much they were going to be able to bring over on this T side.
Yeah,
Mirage, and they just didn't really seem to bring all that much. Even after the pause, they had one or two. They had that really good execute on the A bomb site that we saw in one of those rounds.
Only did that once.
They only did that once, and it didn't even work. It's an unfortunate factor. The actual site take went great, but the post plants because they didn't account for like Gob B and I think Tabson in the jungle position and over on the CT side of Firebox just destroyed them after they had gotten the bomb down.
Yeah, I'm kind of wondering why they don't have like more strategies based on basic execution scenarios onto the A and B bomb site, because they seem to be a team that now also with Lomme in there as the coach, they seem to be a team that could benefit a lot from executions like that, putting down the smokes and having some smart players like Kadian, like Glaze in his support role, being able to do that. But obviously that did not happen, and now they have to rack up 14 rounds on the CT side in order to win this. Big on the other side needs 3.
Yeah, and this is essentially do or die now on the pistol, as it has been in some of our, quite a few of our matches actually here, including the one that we just saw previously with Fnatic Academy. Now though, Tabson, he gets to the smoke in time, but does he realize the Rogue players are sneaking up to his left side? They find him, and they take him down. It's not just Tenski, it's also Victor that has tapped away from inside of the market position. He's found Keeve. He does eventually get overwhelmed, but more of the Rogue players are on their way, and they're slowly boxing out the bigger roster. Kadian and Tenski, they've gotten two more. It's already down just next, and he's been lit up to 26 HP. Also, we see Tenski being able to recover there. Take down next, and it is a clean pistol. This is exactly what Rogue needed. And they've got their chance now, but they essentially need to be flawless to get back into this game.
A very important point to mention is that they did get the bomb down big here, so they're going to be full eco this round, and then they're going to be buying air case in the next one, surely. So that could actually be very good for them, as we do see only pistols right now coming in for big. That means AKs in the next one. So how will Rogue be able to deal with these incoming AKs in the next one? Of course, assuming that they'll just win this on, and Bowl actually buying a Zeus and then just shooting it straight to hell. No use of that. So that's money like thrown out of the window, and that could be a problem, because on this CT side it's very hard to get an economy going unless you're just winning 5 rounds in a row.
Yeah, and we can see now with, again, Big just going to be grouping up, probably just a big play after some waiting, of course, on the timer into one of these two sites. P250s across the board, not even a smoke either, which is the part that's a bit unusual considering how light the investment is across the rest of the players. I normally see one guy going for like the smoke and flashbangs that they can try to just overwhelm the site and get that second plant, but it's not even the case here. It's a full save.
Wow.
And Tenski tries to go for the jumping frag, but is actually dinked midair down to 6 HP.
Yeah, that's a good start to the round from Big. Let's see if they can continue on. And actually one more spotted there by Bubble, I think, down in mid, but Victor and Glaze both shutting it down. Glaze on short. And he is about to get a second one as they boost into mid, though. So this could be a problem for the CTs as next goes down on short. Still one player boosted into mid. Tenski takes him out with 6 HP to spare. He has switched his weapon up with his teammate, but still manages to survive.
Yeah, they're not even going to get close to that plan, unfortunately, in the second round there. So pretty quickly shut out, and Rogue looking clean, as you were mentioning, the economy factor there. The Zeus isn't that big of a deal. Like I said, it's like $200, so that's all just get tossed away.
Every single dollar matters, please. But yeah, I agree. Hopefully that's not going to be too much of an issue. Surely it's not. Because if Rogue can continue playing this way and they can just get rounds and work them in one by one, they might have a chance of doing the comeback, but still, it's going to be incredibly hard for them. And now we do see the 4 AKs and a bunch of flashbangs, and of course Legia with 2 flashbangs going for the Galil instead. But Glaze shot and got B up pretty much early on into this round. But here we go. One player hiding behind the smoke, and that's Kadian.
Legia has not even seen him currently. Kadian's got a perfect flank going on. He can single-handedly shut this one out. There's one. There is two.
No!
And no, he runs out of ammo on the third one. So he's free to push through, picks up one more kill, still goes down to Kadian. However, he could have saved one of his teammates' lives.
Yeah, that is true. Hopefully he grabs up another rifle instead of that MP9, and I'll carry on that into the next round. So Rogue looking quite good, and at least a lot better than they were in the first half of this game, but we still have to see that real battle where Keeve gets an AWP and starts opening out angles, starts opening up bomb sites.
I think he wanted to jump and he missed the jump. He wanted to knife him there.
Yeah, Kadian, he's a cheeky one.
So now Big again back down onto an eco round here. Just going to be what appears right now to be a rush into the B bomb site. They do have utility this time, but that's actually a really well placed nade. both Legia and Nex both losing about 40 HP off of that one. That'll hold them back for a couple of extra seconds. I mean, Victor's ready with a Molotov here too, so they are going to get held up at this one. Actually, the Molotov gets wasted. It goes into the smoke that's deployed, and Nex gets that first kill clean. Not only this too, but you can see Glaze is completely smoked off. That's a nice shot from Tenski, and Tenski's going to burn Legia too, along with that nade hitting Gabi once again. But no! Glaze didn't even realize that Gabi went into that corner, so he's going to be able to tap him down. Tenski and Bubble though, training things out again, and it's all on Gabi in the 1v3. As he tries to hold on to this, it's not going to play out, as Bubble shuts it down with the final kill.
So now we do see Big coming in onto the buy round after another win from Rogue. They've managed to scrape themselves six rounds together. That's decent, but they need to add even more. And now we're going to see the Terrace team on the money, hopefully going for something a tad more serious. And maybe we're going to see one of the famous Gorbi executes. It's not going to be an op this time around, so opting for full utility. And this might be the execute that we have been waiting for.
Going directly over towards A. Everybody leading up to the ramp right now. Nobody in Palace either. As everybody's grouped up here. And with utility, I imagine the execute coming after a little bit of delay here. Keep in mind, though, that the longer they wait on this, the larger the possibility that someone just sneaks right up mid. So in they go, wasting no time on it, but nobody checking up on the platform right now. Victor is free, along with Glaze, to rock up the kills. 3 for 3, however, it's evenly traded. Big still manages to bring it down to 2, but look at how lit both of the remaining big players are. 16 HP combined, whereas Kadian's still at full. He's had no involvement in this up to this point. Tenski, though, is also down at 9. There's Keeve actually finding Kadian, so it falls to Tenski to try and clutch this out with only 9 HP, and he only has a single flashbang to do with. He knows where one is, and oh! Actually, Nex just runs right into the spray, so he's gonna take him down, and this is an even battle now. Tenski's hoping that Keeve goes out into the open. He does catch that first flashbang, but he's looking to the wrong side right now. He may have spot on the left, and no! Keeve peeks right into it, so Tenski's gonna be able to get the clutch, and we will see a 7th round coming up for Rogue.
And you will pick up the AWP as well, because he does have that kit, so he has time to go and get the AWP, go get the defuse in. And that was a close one. Really, really close from Big to shut that one down. But Rogue mounting the comeback. Now it's kind of looking real. It was looking very, very tough after that first half. But getting the pistol round, getting the first buy round, and getting this one as well. Now it's looking serious, but still, if we look at the money at BIG on the big side, they're going to have money to do an AWP for Keeve, and that's where the real problems start for Rogue. Because, let's face it, Kerrigan, or not Kerrigan, Kadian, another Dane, is not on the level of Keeve right now, AWP-wise.
See Keeve moving out here now too, and they're actually a little bit cautious of an aggression play at mid. It's been a while since you've seen one from Rogue, but earlier on in this happened, in the first like couple of rounds in the anti-ecos, they were actually really fond of doing that too. So since then, on their gun rounds, they haven't really been wanting to risk that. Kadian almost actually times that shot well, but I think he's a second or two too late to be able to knock out Keeve, who went for that cross.
See here, Tapson coming in from underpass, trying to get some map control, get some knowledge about where the CTs are posted up right now. We did see not Glaze, but Kadian go for the aggressive peek onto short, now has pushed back or fallen back a bit. Glaze still in here in middle, and Tenski holding that connector as well, so this is going to be an interesting push. Looks like it's going to be a split A through connector, but let's just wait a second and see, because Tenski is holding this angle perfectly, so if they go in that way, they're probably going to get shut down.
Still, it remains quiet over here as Big did get control of middle, something that actually Rogue was struggling with quite a bit until the very end of their regulation T half. Now we can see that they moved into it, but this is always the big issue with getting that mid control too, is actually moving outside of it and getting control of one of the sites from there. You need someone either to push the apartments if you're going B, or a very successful like ramp push or a palace push from the A site too, to be able to help you out and at the very least act as a distraction so you can funnel in through one of the connectors. Tenski still holding in this corner. That's a nice timing on the boost up there too. Legi and Keeve play that together well. They catch Kadian just as he was wrapping the corner, and it lines up for the headshot angle. Tenski though, able to trade, but he peeks into the open where we will see Keeve capitalizing upon that. But then Glaze chimes in once again with another kill against Legia. It's still even, however, 3v3, and Glaze goes a little bit too far into that smoke. That's where Keeve is going to take him down, but Bubble back in it again. It's another 2v2 situation in the post plan, but Bubble wastes no time. Unfortunately, he walks right into the upshot of Keeve. Victory is going to catch Keeve on the cross there, so a trade once again, but now we're in the 1v1, and Gabi holds strong from back over in the jungle position. It's up to Victor to be able to find him, but he's going to wait the timer out a little bit here, hoping he peeks. He gets it, but it's Gabi that has him in the angle advantage, and he will shut it down for Big.
Yeah, very nice play for Big, but I have to say, Rogue are making a lot of these mistakes that we saw them making before this global challenge land, where they're just not up to snuff in the important rounds here, and it's sad to see, but then again, of course, it's awesome awesome to see a team like Big really capitalizing and punishing them on these mistakes. So they know definitely how they're going to play against this team. And that might even take them to the victory here, because now they're on 14. Rogue on this scrappy buy where one of the players has a FAMAS. Some of the players are missing smokes and flashbangs. So this is the time for Big to go all in and just get this round done.
It's still going to be pretty passive, though, in the opening couple seconds of the round. Neither team wanting to face off against each other early on, but Big definitely leaning towards a B hit earlier. Here, as we can see, Keeve and, I believe, Legia already grouped up there inside of the apartment, getting ready for that push. And the three others, which were initially holding back towards T-Spawn, now grouping up to move in with very little delay on this, too. It's going to be Kadian up against the world here, but he does find the first target fairly easily. Legia goes right down, and he falls back, preparing for a rush.
Good position from Kadian. I really like this. Taking the first duel, winning that, and then rotating to a more defensive one. That is how you should play this AWP position. And, well, smoke goes down there from the CT, so that's blocked off for another 10, 15 seconds before they can kind of run through that. And that actually allows Kadian to switch back into the aggressive position. I'm not sure if I like this, to be honest.
And as they move in, Kadian preparing for it. He catches next as he leaps out of the window. It's a midair shot for him. Both the CTs get hit with flashbangs, but there's no movement on it at all from the Big roster here. They completely missed that opportunity, and now they have to try and find their way out of the palace. The good news is that nobody's covering the window, as Kadian did fall back, and he's going to miss that flick. Bumble, though, having better luck, he's going to find Gabi. Glaced through the smoke, finds Taps and able to trace the spray. And for Keeve, there's no hope now. He's lost the bomb. He's lost essentially everything, and he's just going to try to fall back and get as many frags as he can. Nice. And that won't be any at all. Kadian shuts it down with his third kill of the round, putting up, I believe, an eighth for Rogue.
Yeah, definitely. Kadian taking the chance then, going for that aggressive peek. And if he hadn't hit that mid-air shot, he probably died straight out afterwards. That's a bit of a gamble. But let's be honest, they're in a situation where they have to take gambles every single round to mount this comeback. Look at that mid-air shot. Nice.
Damn.
But that's finally, Kadian has awoken with that AWP, because they need him to step onto the level that Keeve is at least trying to get on. Because let's face it, Keeve is better, but Kadian has to do his absolute best to give Rogue a chance in this matchup. And once again, they need to win 8 rounds in a row, Blue, to win this one. That's a lot to ask.
It looks like Rogue have been pretty hard-headed on going for those A pushes. It's kind of the same situation with Big and these B pushes, yeah, too, as they've been wanting to go for it. There's Tenski, though, with a shutdown on the Legia. Big, however, on the Seeker round, not expecting anything too great from them. And at the moment, Tenski just kind of cleaning up shop there. Struggled to get that third kill, and he got a little bit low, so he does decide to finally fall back. So that'll hand over mid control to the guys on Big. But obviously, with this kind of an arsenal, they still have a lot more work to do if they want to have any sort of impact on this round.
So let's see here. 3 pistols remaining. Probably not going to be the round that is going to allow Big to get on 15, but surely the round after, with the talent they have on this lineup, they're going to be able to rack something up. Kadian shots Taps and down. Now it's all on next and got B. And this round is almost over here, as we do see the Germans trying to move in. Kadian's just holding it down.
As he's found Gabi, it's come to Nex, and there's no reason for Nex to really try to do anything creative. He'll just give his life away, holding a cheeky corner, hope he can try to find a headshot or two against these guys to knock them out. And beyond that, obviously, this will definitely still be a 9th round for Rogue, so they are starting to close that gap, but there is still the ultimate doom kind of working against them, and the fact that Big really only needs to pick up 2 more rounds here, and they close it out. So just like how small the lead may now be for Big, they still are very, very close to victory should they find some consistency on their T side.
Yeah, so far it's been a very good game for both Tenski and Nex, who are topping the scoreboard, and I have to say, so happy to see Nex back in a row where he can lead that scoreboard, he can really be the star of the team. Kadian doing good work finally with the AWP, so this match is actually shaping up after a, let's say, terrible first half, shaping up to a really interesting game of CS, because these two teams, when they are firing on all cylinders, doing their very best, they are two incredible teams to watch.
Well, we do have Big lining up in the B halls once again. No surprises there, as they do think I have to go for the double save now too.
Yeah.
Just on the PT-50s, they do get a little bit more utility this time, so they can try to smoke off a couple angles on that B site. However, there's a lot more on the Rogue side, and they're able to molly that off and basically delay this for as long as they can. They can easily outmatch that of what Big is going to bring to the table.
So let's see here what's going to happen. Push coming in towards middle. They want to go do that split B, short and B Palace. Tenski actually pushed all the way back, so good job by Big getting him down to 13 and forcing him back. Now they have to take care of Victor and Glaze on this B bomb side, but Glaze is in position, takes down next. 3 players remaining from the Big team.
Glaze nicely done, swiping away in one of those last kills there, and pretty straightforward from Rogue. They only lose bubbles, so this is clean too, and this is what they need on these very small rounds, just to make these, just to take as little loss as possible, that they stack up their own economy here. As should we see still that one round, one from Big? The most important thing for Rogue is going to be their ability to rebuy just as large of a pickup directly into the next round and be able to reset Big and then use that little bit of a boost to try and at the very least take this into overtime.
And as you say that, we actually just see the money. That's actually looking quite okay. So if they win this one and then lose straight after, they will be able to rebuy completely and get that AWP on Kadian again and get full utility. So that's something for them. There's still a chance, despite even if Big takes this one. So that's looking good. Kadian winning the orb duel against Legia, and that's a good start to the round for the Danes, but still, the Germans have so much firepower, so question is, can they utilize that to take over one of these bomb sites?
So again, though, leaning still towards that B bomb site. At the very least, though, they are keeping a bit of a player to act as a distraction over on the A site. As we can see, it is going to be it's going to be Nex hiding out there in the palace to act as a little bit of a late push. However, with four still on the A site, big question is going to be now if Big will still be sticking with that B hitter, if they're going to change it up. You can see that the bomb was shifted away. He was kind of hiding outside of the halls a moment ago, but now he was in a position mainly so to counter out aggression, though, and he'll certainly get that aggression in a second if he sticks around here. Two players pushing into him. There's the first one, and there's no follow-up at all from Victor. He'll fall back, but I highly doubt he's going to move into it now that he's wasted that much time.
Yeah, I don't understand really why you want to do this push if you don't want to go directly for the revenge kill, because then it's just, if someone is holding that angle and you can't do the instant revenge kill, then it's just basically hoping that one peeking man gets the kill, or else it's just throw away a free death to your opposition. So that makes no sense to me at all. But nonetheless, it's good for the German players as they now move in towards this A split. Just Victor looking here. Keep going for the no-scope, but now the bomb is down. They can hold this bomb. And with Kadian coming in, getting too quick with the AWP. Next, taking down Glace. But still, it's going to be an incredible big ask for him to clutch this 1v3. He's a great player, but surely no way he can do this. Going in for the first one, not getting it done. Victor takes him out. And that's round number 11 in the Rogue comeback.
And although we did criticize it earlier, that is where that aggression from Victor is justified. And the fact that he pushes in there and holds that angle after so much time has gone by, easily like 20 to 30 seconds after we saw that first kill happening, it's very safe to assume from the teaser that he would have fallen back into a safer position. But the fact that he sticks around there, it is a sudden surprise, like, oh, there is all of a sudden still a second guy hanging out here, and it catches them off guard.
That I agree with.
There's a bug on the window there.
Hello, bug.
Very big bug.
How are you doing today?
I hate bugs. Well, Big are going to go into a tactical pause here since things are getting a bit dodgy now. And they may have to work a little bit harder just to close out this game, since Rogue are closing the gap once again, and I believe they're just within three rounds, actually, of tying this up. They could, in theory, just close it out in regulation.
I'm pretty sure that Big are actually going to be on a pistol buy this round, so they're not going to be in a full buy. That means that probably Rogue are going to be on 12, 14 before Big can actually buy weapons. So that's going to be very, very interesting, and that's probably what they're talking about now. Okay, what are we going to do in this Tech 9 smoke round, perhaps? Get the bomb down, and then what are we going to do in the buy round after that? Are we going to run double AWP setup on the T side? Not likely, but definitely going to get an AWP onto Kiev. And now Gopi, of course, the man in the picture right now, sitting here thinking about what are we going to do, getting that communication out towards the players, and surely they're going to be ready. Of course, man in the picture right now, the new coach for Rogue, former Heroic coach Lomé, him in unison with Kadian in the middle here, the in-game leader for Rogue, are the ones making the decisions, taking some feedback there from, I think, Tenski. And surely every single player going to be ready when this pulse expires.
It should be expiring here in about 30 seconds or so. So we should be ready to jump back into the action here as Big are still looking. It's been the T-sides here that have been real troublesome, really, for both of these teams. The CTs have been basically dominating the playing field here, and I think it's overall due to a lack of variety when it comes to executes here. Both of these teams have been playing very predictable and very easy to read T-sides, and although the CT sides are looking great, it's all just because of the fact that the T's aren't really doing anything super creative. It's very easy to make these call-outs and rotate into them once they get the early intel.
Yeah, so far we've had three rounds on the T-side being won by terrorists. That's absolutely insane. And that has been two for Rogue on their T side and only one so far on the Big T side. And now we jump back into the game. 14-11, round number 26 coming up. And as I said earlier, it's going to be this pistol round coming in for Big. They are saving for the next one. They're going to buy up in the next one. So now they're just looking to get the bomb down, see if they can do any economical damage onto Rogue in this.
Molotov was going to hold the early aggression from Legia off for a moment here too. Nothing too big to worry about, but Victor actually is allowed to push in, and that's a beautiful lineup against Legia. Absolutely destroys him. And with that already, Big, you're going to lose one of their crucial players in to this early round situation. Keep in mind, again, they're ecoing here, so this is not a round that we expect too much from them, but still, knocking a guy like that out is going to give a lot of control over to the Rogue roster and to sort of help to, again, get the read as far as what the situation is going to be for this T side and where they will eventually execute towards.
So a bit of a noise made on that T platform, and now they're going to set up the smokes. I think this is for the A split. So the two players here in mid, they're going to rush straight down into connector. The two guys are going to meet up from A main, and then they're going to try and sandwich these two players on the A bomb side. Let's see here as they come in.
Going Tenski will line up first against this. Unfortunately, he won't be able to see all that much. He's stuck back out. Bubble, though, there's nobody that smoked him out. He's free to fire these shots. And now Kadian chiming in from the backside of the connector. He legs one of the final ones alive, and Tenski will do the job to finish things off. Gobby's now the last man standing with a CZ. He picks up one. There's a lot more on its way, and he'll run out of ammo. Try to play with cover to stay alive. He gets dinked through the box, still at 67 HP, and he actually grabs one more before going down to Victor. Still, though, it will be a round for Rogue as they continue to inch closer and closer to 14 and tying this matchup.
And they're building the economy as well, so this is really good for their comeback, to be honest. They have two players around the 7 to 10k mark after buying in this one. Actually, they have one player and then one player in 7k, so that's really good. And Kadian, of course, the AWP player, the most important player to keep alive. He's on 10k, so that's really good for him. But look at Tenski going off 26 to 15. That's perfect from him.
And he's been the guy in mid here too, edging off quite a few of these kills in the early round. Big have got a little bit too aggressive for their own good there. He's been able to, you know, shut down quite a few of them in the early round situations, and along with playing into the A side too, and Big have decided to push in that avenue.
See here, Keeve with the AWP on that T side. Very important to get him on that weapon because he's just absolutely dangerous when he goes into sides and can open up pretty much any side on any map with that AWP. Has one smoke to kind of position himself with, but he still needs to get something done before doing so. And actually also Kadian once again with the AWP on that CT side, running the old JW combo, CSET 75 and AWP, but not as effective as it was back in the day with the lower switch time where you could just gun everyone down.
Big still looking for their way into one of these sites. Still plenty of time left, so it's not too worrying if they haven't moved forward yet. However, the fact that they're still so far back with so little time to work with is what we're going to have to worry about in a moment here. But 45 seconds, they are starting to move into it. However, out comes Tenski as that smoke did start to fade away in mid. He grabs one, but overstays his welcome in the open. And that's where Tabson is going to capitalize to take him down. A 4v4 is what will be brought down to. And in a moment here, they are going to actually, I think, be forced into an XQ because the bomb has gone down over there in the connector. So they kind of have to switch it up last minute. And this is not going to be good because this is acting on a whim here. They did not prepare for this whatsoever. Bubble is ready for it as they do try to smoke themselves into it. They're trying to set up at the last second, but if even one player holds up for one or two kills, this is where they're going to stop them. That's Tapson and Keeve picking up two very crucial kills. And they pre-fire into Victor's position. Beautifully played. And finally, another round for Big does to bring out there.
Wonderful execute and wonderful battles being taken there by Big. And despite them being forced into that A execute, that worked up absolutely perfectly for them. So very well played. And here we see replay of Tapson winning that duel. He should not have been able to win it, but his stellar aim just takes him out there and just inches in and takes out the player in shadow as well. So that's really good. And now Big on 15 to 12. They can take map one right here, but luckily for Rogue, they had that economy we talked about earlier, so they can easily rebuy into this one. But of course, if they lose this, it's all over on map one. So they have to go all in, have to take some risks here.
Bigger still holding back again over there towards the top mid. It worked for them in the last round, so they're going to try it again in this round. A bit of a good luck in coming in from that last round, however, and the fact that they were able to pick up the entry so well. But considering the fact that that had to be due to a last-second changeup, still a bit worrying in that it could have gone the complete other direction should have Rogue's players had a little bit better aim in that situation.
Yeah, definitely. So here we do see Thompson just holding defensively, as the rest of his team is right now, just holding back, making sure that nothing crazy is going on from Rogue, making sure that they are in their position as well, just waiting out the time before they are going in for their execute. Tapson is actually in a very aggressive position, so he's going to be the spearhead if they want to go into this split A. And right now, two players rotating back onto A main, so they're going to go two from mid and then three from A main, I think. That's going to be the play for Big. They have had recent success on this bomb site, so surely they're going to go for it again. But once again, we see this aggression coming in towards A ramp, and let's see if it pays out.
And as they move in, Keeve, actually a bit of an uncharacteristic miss from him, considering how well he has been doing in this matchup to this point. But no follow-through on the Rogue side. They're happy with just forcing him away. And they do not want to go out too far, where there obviously is a very big stack of players in that T side. They'll still hold the position. Victor waiting in this corner, but Keeve on the re-peak shuts down Victor. Now Tenski's turn to battle with these guys as they don't actually check over into the room. So Tenski's free to grab his first kill. Taps and trades it. Glaze with another one. Leggear from the backside picks up one more for the T's. It's going to be a 2v2 as the bomb does start to go down, and they will attempt to pre-fire from the ticket spot, but no damage really connecting. And Keeve lines it up against Glaze. Now it's Kadian 1v2, and he's been flashed into a corner, wasting about 5 seconds away here, and he's got no more utility. Smoke's in the way. He's not going to be able to find Keeve back there as he's tucked safely in the corner. And over to Cadian's left as he goes up too far, he will find an opponent. He actually finds the head, but fires way too slowly on that one. So he's going to miss his chance in that regard. Switches over to the CZ to try to push back in. He's hoping to find the guy on Tetris. Won't find it, but the swing shot gets the headshot onto that first kill. He'll jump onto this defuse, hoping he can get Leggy into the open. Looks directly into that flash, tries to time the shot. The shots are missing, however, so we almost saw a whiff from Leggy, but it's not the case. It will be Big finally shutting things down over here on Mirage to take control of map number one.
What a great game so far. What a great start to this best of three between two very interesting teams. Big taking it. And Rogue trying to mount the comeback, doing really well, but in the end, it will be the Germans winning out. And what a round in the end there. Keeve just so on point during this game. 26-21 is his scoreline on the scoreboard after this game, and definitely the man to watch. But on the other side, on that CT side, Tenski did very well. Cadian got started with the AWP in the end of that game, and he actually also did really well on the CT side, but definitely a questionable T side by both teams.
It's always a little bit crushing, too, for a team, I mean, any team, really, to start off from that far behind one half to basically make the comeback.